Average Cost Curve, Part 1. As a first step in deriving the long-run average cost curve, let us try to understand a few basics. We shall start like this. Before commencing production, a firm acquires land, building and machinery. These are all fixed factors. The cost incurred on these items is called fixed cost. It is the fixed cost which determines the plant size or size of the firm. After that, the firm spends on raw materials, electricity and labor to commence production. These are all variable factors. Cost incurred on such items is called variable cost. Variable cost will not change the plant size, but by altering the variable cost, the firm can alter the output. By increasing the variable cost, the firm can increase its output. Since the firm works with a given size of plant by varying its variable cost, the firm is said to operate in a short run. It works with a short run average cost curve. The average cost curve is a U-shaped curve. Initially, it falls because of the law of increasing returns. After reaching the minimum, average cost rises due to the law of decreasing returns. It means, beyond the minimum point with the existing plant, the firm can produce a larger output only at a high average cost. The increasing height of the yellow colored line shows this. So, more output with less cost is possible only if the firm changes the size of the plant. The firm changes its size by increasing the fixed cost. After changing the size, the firm enters into another short run. Accordingly, its variable cost is also altered. The new plant encounters a new cost function. It means the firm has to use a new average cost curve. Thus, the firm moves from one short period to another short period by changing the plant size. In each period, it uses a short-run average cost curve that is relevant to that plant size. For example, in short period 1, the firm uses ACAC1. In short period 2, it uses ACAC2. A firm can conceive a number of such short-run average cost curves. We are going to derive the long-run average cost curve using these short-run average cost curves. Finally, we shall summarize what we have learnt so far. Long-run consists of a number of short periods. When the firm moves from one short period to another short period, fixed factors change, fixed cost changes. The plant size changes. The scale of operation changes. Scale of operation, we mean a change in output due to a change in the plant size. In each short period, firm will have an average cost curve of that period. That ends our discussion on basics of long-run average cost curve. We shall meet again in part 2.